So let's start from lecture 5. So today we're gonna start with infinite series. Right? Series has a sort of connection, right? Sequence has no connection. Okay, so that's the actually the difference between these two. So if you're talking about the series, so that means we actually connect the sequence with the sign of plus or minus, right? It may be any sign. So let En be a sequence, right? And the series will be of the form A1 plus A2 plus A3 and so on An. Is it okay? So we're talking about the series or the sequence, these are infinite. You're talking about these things, that means they're infinite. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what we actually want, so we actually, you know, notate it with a slightly different form. That is, let's say n runs from 1 to infinity, an. So that actually means what? Of course, this one. So summation is used just to give a more compact form to the sequence, series, right? So now we'll also, of course, we'll be interested in the part that whether this thing is going to be finite or infinite. We'll always be discussing this. We'll be always interested in this part. Okay? Right?
Yes, sir.
Right? Yes, sir.
So that's the idea we want to discuss. Okay. So, but before going to that, that is pretty much interesting that we'll be mostly, you know, talking about this, we'll be talking about the series, but in terms of the sequence. How? That I'm going to discuss right now. Okay. So that is our first thing over here. We call it as partial sums.
Sir?
Yes?
Can you just repeat what you highlighted in that green box like thing?
Yeah, this is nothing, just a short form. This is just a short form of this, right? Let's say partial sums. Okay, so we have partial sums. So partial sums. So we have A1. So that is what? S1. And A1 plus A2. That means we'll take the sum of first two terms, right? And we call it as S2. A1 plus A2 plus A3 is S3, right? So that means that's what sum of the first term, of course, only first term, sum of first two terms, right? And then sum of first three terms and so on. Sum of first four terms, right? And so on. If you keep on moving like this, you will have Sn, which would be A1 plus A2 plus so on A. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So, yes, sir.
Now you see that this becomes, your Sn becomes summation n or k runs from 1 to n ak. Right? So if you take limit n tends to infinity both sides. So what does that mean? Can you tell me what does that mean?
Infinity till infinity.
Infinity terms.
So that means if this sequence is convergent, then this series is convergent?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Every time I'm adding S1, S2, S3, right? So finally my Sn would be the sum of nth terms. And if we take n tends to infinity, then this sequence actually representing the limit of this sequence is actually representing the sum of this infinite series. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So what we say, therefore, a series will be convergent.
Can you please explain what you just said again? I was not able to understand.
So sorry. If you are not able to understand, let me put it again. So what I'm saying is, say you have S1, that was A1. So you have S2, that was A1 plus A2. And you have S3, A1 plus A2 plus A3, right? So now, what is your S infinite? Let's say A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus so on, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Are you getting this? Now, yes. This sum will be finite only if this number will be finite.
Yes, sir.
Right? Yes, or in other words, I would say Sn. That is, if it is coming out to be L, that means this sum is coming out to be L.
Yes,
is
sir.
It okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now see this. So the point I want to make is the infinite series will be convergent if and only if the corresponding sequence of partial sums is convergent. Is it fine? Are you getting the point now?
Yes, sir.
So basically, I want to say that, okay, if you are talking about series, then we can also explain the series in terms of the sequence of partial sums. Is it fine? So that is one of the most important point, right, which we are talking about right now. Okay. So,
sir,
yes.
Please show the previous page.
Yes, sir.
So could you please explain those definition again?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. See, you can see that. You can see that. I mean, these two things are same.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Right. So
yes,
this,
sir.
If this part is finite, then this part is finite.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So if this is convergent, then this is convergent.
Yes, sir.
But if you see your S1, S2, S3, S4, this is what? Sequence. Right?
Yes, sir.
But this part, the right-hand side part is what? Series. Why? Because it is connected by this plus sign every time. Right? So that means a series is convergent only if the corresponding sequence of partial sum is convergent. And it is divergent if the corresponding sequence of partial sum is divergent. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Can we move forward?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see that. So now, you know, the basic series which you have already done, maybe in plus one class, that is geometric series. So again, if I'm talking about the series over here, I'm talking about only infinite series, not the finite one, right? So we know that it is of the type what? A plus AR plus AR square and so on. And we sometimes write it in this way as well, that n runs from 1 to infinity AR n minus 1. And we know that this sum will be finite if what? If your R is?
R is less than equal to 1.
R is less.
Not equal to, only strictly less than. Okay. So A upon 1 minus R. That is your, you know, the sum of the corresponding series. Otherwise, it will be divergent. And you know that if you want to find out the sequence of partial sum, let's say Sn. So that means you need to add only how many terms?
N terms. R raised to power n minus 1.
Yes, we need n minus 1 terms. Okay, so now this sum can be calculated and we know that. What is your Sn?
A into R upon 1 minus R.
And you, if you calculate limit intensity Sn, that becomes A upon 1 minus R.
Minus R.
Because, Now, of course, your mod R should be less than 1.
Yes, sir.
True?
Yes, sir. True?
Okay. So, let's say next. So, is it fine?
Can you just switch to the previous page?
Yes, yes. From one? Please.
Done.
Okay. So let's check about few series which probably you have already done maybe. So for an example. Okay. So we have say let's say 1/4 + 1/4² + 1/4³ and so on up to infinity. Right. So that S infinite is equal to A upon 1 minus R. R is again 1/4. So that is 1/4 / 3/4. So that three. Becomes
1/3.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So next part is, there are so many things which can be done over here. So let's say we have another example. Let's say we have another example that is determine the value of this. So how are we going to do? We know that our first term will become 1/3, second -1/3² + 1/3³ - 1/3¾. This is alternating sign, right? Alternating signs are appearing in the series. So A upon 1 minus R, right? Is it fine?
1/4. Yes. Yes, sir.
4/3. So answer one for this four. Would 1/4. Yeah, four. That's fine. Okay. So next we something we call it as telescoping series. That you also have done, I guess.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. VN
method. We started the previous page.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, is it VN method?
What?
Sir, is it VN method, sir, the telescoping series?
Telescoping series means, we represent the series in such a way that infinitely terms will get cancelled and we are only left with the finitely many terms.
Yes,
that's
sir.
It. Okay, is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, let's say. If we talking about the telescoping series, so we'll talk about the pretty much easy example of that. And let's say that is 1/(n)(n+1). Right. So if you see this is not going to be a telescoping series at a glance. But if you write it in this way. Will this work?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you expand it, that becomes 1/(1 - 1/2). You put n is equal to 1 over here. Then you put n is equal to 2 over here. Then you put n is equal to 3 over here. And so on, right?
Only first and the last one.
Not last one, because we are dealing with the infinite.
Talking about infinity.
Right? So we have only first term. So that is 1.
One.
True? So can you do it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir,
can we calculate the SN, sir? SN RS ke baad hum dal sakte hain infinity.
Of course. That's what I'm trying to do here. Okay?
Yes,
so in the next step, so let's say you're talking about SN. So that means you're talking about N terms, right? So that means you will write the same sum as this is your first term, this is your second term, and so on. When you reach at the nth term, here you will have N and here you will have n plus 1. So as you have said, now we are dealing with the finite sum. That's why all terms will get cancelled except first and the last. So you are left with two terms over here. Okay. So now if you take limit n tends to infinity Sn, so it becomes limit
one, n. One is the answer.
Yeah.
One.
So again, the answer will be same, right? So it would be 1.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
True?
So there are two ways to check it. Now, you know, the interesting part of the of this whole story is what? See, we were dealing with the sequences and we were actually finding the limits. Most of the time, we were be able to find the limit, or otherwise, we were able to tell at least that whether this sequence is convergent or divergent, right? But here, the most interesting part is, most of the time, you will not be able to tell this, that what is the actual answer. You can get actual answer only in these two cases. One is geometric
series, and
another is
telescoping series.
Now, in the subsequent lectures, we'll be dealing only with the things that we'll be able to tell whether this is convergent or divergent. That's it. So we cannot tell the exact answer. So what is the exact sum of this? Most of the cases, we will not be able to tell the exact answer. We'll only conclude whether it is convergent or it is divergent. Is it fine? So now,
yes, sir.
There is an important result. We also call it as nth divergent test, right? Nth term divergence test. So let's see how it works. Okay. The theorem, pretty much easy. Okay. So that's what, if n runs from 1 to infinity an converges, then limit n tends to infinity an has to be 0. Right?
Yes, sir.
So now, see, keep in mind that this is whole series, right? And this is just the nth term of the series, just the nth term. It is not the nth partial sum. It is not nth partial sum. It is just one term. It is just the last term of nth partial sum, right? So let me explain how it works. So now, given that summation n runs from 1 to infinity an is convergent, okay? So that means it is something which is finite, right? So let it is equal to S. True? It is equal to S? Can we write in this way?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is your sequence of, what is your partial sum? If you talk about partial sum, what is that? Sn? And what is Sn? How you write it to Sn?
K is equal to 1 to n.
Ak. Right? Okay. And yes. What is your Sn minus 1?
N minus 1.
N minus 1. Okay. So can you tell me what is the difference between Sn and Sn minus 1?
An.
Only an. Right? Because we have done that part, right?
From, yes, sir.
From here onwards, we are doing what? We are in S2, we are adding A2. And what is the difference between S2 and S3? We are adding one more term in S3, that is A3. That means the subsequent term, right? In the same way, in what is the difference between S4 and S3? We are adding one more term, and that is what? A4, right? So, yes. So if you consider the difference of these two, Sn and Sn minus 1, and that difference would be nothing but An, right?
Yes,
now, if you take limit n tends to infinity on both sides, okay. This is Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Now your series is convergent. Now your series is convergent and it has a certain sum, and that sum is S. Then of course the sequence of partial sum is also convergent.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And this will converge to the same value, so both will become
yes,
S.
Sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
So that
yes,
means. So therefore, so we will say that since this series is given to be convergent, therefore Sn sequence of partial sum. Therefore, sequence of partial sums, that is Sn, will converge to S, say, right? You say it's converging to S. So that means this will become what? So this will become S minus S limit n tends to infinity An, right? So that means limit n tends to infinity An has to be equal to zero, right? But
yes, sir.
So this is necessary condition, right? So let me put few notes over there. First of all,
So previous page, please.
Yes, please.
सर अगर एक सीक्वेंस कन्वर्जेंट है तो जो हमने इसके पार्शियल सम लिए थे एस एन और एस एन माइनस वन ये भी कन्वर्जेंट दोनों सेम उस पे होंगे जैसे आपने एस पे कन्वर्जेंट है दोनों
ऑफ कोर्स बिकॉज वी आर टेकिंग एन टू इनफाइनाइट सो वेदर इट इज एन माइनस वन एन माइनस टू एन माइनस टेन एन माइनस टेन थाउजेंड इट डजंट मैटर वी आर ग्रोइंग एन टू इनफाइनाइट ओके राइट सो कैन वी मूव फॉरवर्ड
यस सर
So what we are saying, the converse of the above theorem is not true. But we are not going to do that right now. Okay. Is not true. Okay. Secondly, the above test is used to detect the divergence only. Right? So what does it mean? So idea is what? So idea is you take limit n tends to infinity. A series will be given to you, right? A series like this will be given to you. And you are asked to check the convergence or divergence of this series. So what do you do? So you first take limit n tends to infinity only an. If it is coming out to be non-zero, then you say that the series is divergent.
Yes, sir.
But since the converse is not true, so if limit n tends to infinity an is coming out to be zero, then you cannot say anything. Right, then you cannot say anything. We cannot say anything. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Sir, एक बार फिर explain करो.
एक बार repeat कर दो.
ठीक है. मैं अभी example से करूँगा explain. फिर तुम्हें समझ आएगा. ठीक है?
Okay.
So let's say. So, examples. So, let's say I have given this thing to you. So, you know that it is divergent, right? But one way to check is what? You take, compare it with this An. So, here An is what? N cube?
Yes, sir.
So you simply take limit n tends to infinity n cube. That would be what? Infinite?
Infinite.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is not going to zero?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right? So by divergence, we will simply say that therefore summation n cube is divergent. Right?
Yes, sir.
Is it fine? Okay. Yes,
sir. Sir, zero to kya tend kar rahe hain?
मैंने कहा जीरो पे नहीं टेंड कर रहा है मैंने क्रॉस लगाया है ठीक एंड इन द सेम वे सी सो लेट्स से अनदर एग्जांपल सो यू आर आस्क्ड दिस वन द लास्ट वन वाज प्रीटी इजी एक्चुअली यू नो दैट n स्क्वायर विल n क्यूब विल कीप ऑन इंक्रीजिंग राइट बट हियर यू प्रोबब्ली यू नो एट द फर्स्ट साइड यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू डिटेक्ट वेदर इट इज कन्वर्जेंट और डाइवर्जेंट राइट
कन्वर्जेंट
So let's say again we'll apply that divergence test. So now you compare it with this thing. So therefore here an is what? N plus 1 upon n. So that can be written as 1 upon 1 plus n.
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
now
sir.
Limit n tends to infinity an.
Infinity.
So limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by
one.
N.
One.
So that is what? 1.
One. Again, one.
Not going to 0?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? So yes, therefore, sir. Summation n runs from 1 to infinity n plus 1 upon n is divergent.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
True?
Yes, sir. Yes.
True.
Yes,
you are getting the point. So I'm leaving few examples for you that you can check. Okay. So that's what.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So for convergence, is it necessary that it has to converge to zero?
It has to diverge. It has to. This is the. That's what I'm saying. This is a necessary condition, but not sufficient one. Right. For
yes,
convergence,
sir.
We need it. But reverse is not true. Is it okay? Right?
So, मतलब convergence के लिए इसको zero तक पहुंचना ही होगा।
हाँ, otherwise नहीं, otherwise वो नहीं होगा।
Okay.
ठीक है, okay. Let me put it in another way. So if I say that a vehicle has four tires, and I want to conclude you whether it is a car or not, right? But suppose you check there are only two tires, then you say that it cannot be car, right? But if it has four tires, it still may not be a car.
Yes, sir.
Okay. But if car is there, then the four tires are necessary, right? But not sufficient. Right? You're getting my point? So we'll check the number of tires. If number of tires is coming out to be greater or less than four, of course, in the rational condition. Now, don't say that ki stepney include karni hai nahi. Okay? So, of course, under the rational condition. So if you check the tires, if there are four tires, na, then you cannot conclude. But if there are three tires, you simply say that it's an auto. It can't be a car, or it may be something, another thing, maybe a rickshaw as well. Okay. So if the number of tires are less than the four, then you simply say no car. That means divergent. No convergent. That means divergent. But if it is four, then you cannot say. Then you have to test on the on some other criteria, which we'll be discussing in our subsequent lectures. Okay. So
okay,
now you
yes,
can
sir.
You can check on these as well. So this will not be convergent. Okay. So you may check these two as well. Okay. So these are examples which are actually given. Now I want to give you a few more things. Okay. So now see that. Now, this is something which I generally explain in my terms, which I call it as a slow divergence. See, this is an important example to discuss. That means the counterexample. Counterexample is what? That quotient type example. Okay, where I'm saying that this is happening, but still the series is not convergent. Okay, so let's say. So that part we're going to prove, the counter part. That means example is what? Show that, or this may be asked that give an example to show that summation an can be divergent even if limit n tends to infinity an is 0. Okay? Are you getting the statement? Are you with me on this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Now see, I'll give you the statement. Okay? I'll give you that how it works. Right? So
1 by n?
Yes, 1 by n. Yeah, you are right. If you have already read, then it's 1 by n. Okay, I'll prove that how it works. Okay? So, have you proved the divergence of 1 by n? So, this is the normal example we generally use to prove it is this 1 by n. This is divergent. tomorrow we shall prove that this is divergent, है ना? However, limit n tends to infinity, an अगर उठाओ, that means nothing but 1 by n. So that would be what? Zero. But still it will be divergent.
Divergent. Is it
okay? Yes. So we're gonna prove that
tomorrow. Okay, sir.
Okay. So anything you want to ask?
सर जो हमने पिछले एग्जांपल्स किए अभी जिसमें हम डाइवर्जेंट बता रहे थे तो उसमें हमें कैसे पता कि डाइवर्जेंट है मतलब ये क्वेश्चन उन एग्जांपल्स पे भी तो लग सकती है
किस वाले पे नहीं नहीं उसमें इसलिए नहीं लगेगी ना उनका लिमिट नॉन जीरो जा रहा है देखो
हर केस में
लिमिट नॉन जीरो जा रहा है ना
यस सर
तो इसमें दिस इज द रिजल्ट इफ योर लिमिट इज गोइंग टू नॉन जीरो नंबर देन यू सिंपली से दैट इट इज डाइवर्जेंट But if your limit is coming out to be zero, then you cannot conclude anything.
Okay, right? Okay,
so,
sir. Yes.
So that's what we're gonna prove tomorrow. That will be the counter example. See, the theorem is what? The theorem is I'll again state you the theorem. Theorem is this: if this is convergent, right? If this is convergent, there are two parts, right? Then this thing will happen. But I haven't said the reverse way. That means if this is true if this is true then this will happen I didn't say this right
yes sir yes sir